Hi everyone, my name is Alysha.
And I'm Kennelyn, and we're here to educate you on stress and the effect that it has on your body that you may not have known.
So Kennelyn, did you know that Statistics Canada reported that in 2013, 23% or 6.6 million Canadians reported that most days were quite a bit or very stressful?
Wow, that's a lot.
Yeah, so if you think about it, if Canada were this pie, 23% of this pie would be very stressed out. I don't think I'd want to eat that slice, would you, Kennelyn?
Nuh-uh.
And 60% of students said that most days they experienced overwhelming anxiety. And also, females reported being more stressed than men, which would be a really cool topic to explore, but maybe for another time. So let's jump into defining what stress really means. So stress was coined by Hans Salier in 1936, defining it as the non-specific response of the body to any demand for change, which means stress can be a good thing or a bad thing. Stress is the body's way of protecting you. It keeps you motivated, alert, and focused. Do you remember your first public speech, your first date, every single time you go on a roller coaster? These are all body's positive stress responses, or eustress. But past a certain point, stress negatively impacts pretty much every aspect of your life. Acute stress occurs in short bursts. It's due to the demands of your recent past or your upcoming future. People who experience this frequently can develop coronary heart conditions later on in life. Chronic stress, on the other hand, is the ongoing stress we tend to ignore or push down, just like money, health, relationships, job stress. Left uncontrolled, this stress can also affect your health and your immune system. So let's look at this graph comparing your performance level to your stress level. So as your stress level increases, your performance level increases, but there's an optimal point. Past that, any amount of additional stress can negatively impact your performance level.